Hello friends and family, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to make a really nice summer pruning, a haircut of my pre-bonsai olive tree. And after this pruning session I will share a little bit with you about the ongoing koi filter house build. This tree got to me about 1.5 years ago, and was a very, very cheap nursery material. Living in Sweden, I don't think it makes any sense to buy really expensive olives, because they are not really hardy here. So it's quite a lot of work just keeping them alive. But this year I have been fairly successful. I have quite a lot of olives forming. And I really want to cut it back for a nice canopy, but also to display the fruits a little bit more. So basically I try to cut into this year's growth, leaving one or two pairs of leaves, and paying attention to the overall canopy and where the fruit is. And that's really a balance between several goals. So I just start to work and we see where it lands, okay? So I think we are in a better situation for the canopy. Some shoots needed to be cut back very, very hard, and some just light to try to find the canopy. But it's really growing too much in these sides and too little on the top, and that's really what you want. But in this case, I'm not sure. It's hard to get a nice canopy. But all the fruits is visible, and there are a lot more space for the sun to penetrate. I noticed I have a few bad leaves. I don't know the reason for that, and I don't bother too much. I will take them out to make the crown even more airy and make it easier for the sun to penetrate the healthy leaves. So that's about it. I made it just in time before the rain came. This is the amount of foliage I've been removing, and now I'm just gonna let it grow until winter. Overwinter it frost-free, and sometime in spring there will be major branch selection, because there are far too much branches on this one. I'm gonna take shelter from the rain and get back to you in a bit with the news about the filter house build. Cheers! So I think I have 5 minutes before the next rain, so let's look at this. I want to talk to you about yakisugi, ancient Japanese wood preserving technique. It's basically that they burn it, and when you get the charred surface, it's more resistant to rot, it's more resistant to start burning. That's a really smart way of doing things. And it's possible I have this sample that I got more than a year ago. Basically, you can get the one with a very, very deep charred. Wonderful, wonderful, beautiful. And this one, which is more lightly burned. This one is the one that's most resistant to moist and fire, but it also less resistant to physical damage. You can scrape it like this and it gets really ugly. So this is some of them. There are different species of wood with a softer, let's see, the softer spruce and a little bit more heavy larch wood. And they also sent me this. This is also very beautiful, but not really wood preserving. That's a very light burn for indoor use, so that will not happen in my filter room. And acacia and masuria, I don't know what it's called in English. So yeah, I got this samples sent to me more than a year ago. I've been taking this package out several times and trying to understand which one is the best for me. So there will be yakisugi on the koi filter house. The project is ongoing and the first video is on Saturday. We will have a normal premiere 2000 Central European time. Until then, thanks a lot for watching. Take care, stay safe, bye.